experience with the participants. This makes our institutes very unique and incomparable in the country. At the same time, I do realize that the government departments, particularly the training institutions, suffer from relative disadvantage of the scarcity of necessary training resources, both in terms of human and material. But I also know that even these limited resources, the present administration of the institute has been successful in raising the quality of the training. This is encouraging and it must be appreciated. Ladies and gentlemen, in my opinion, government service is more of a personal and voluntary commitment than a mundane occupation. A diligent government servant works to serve the people through formulating valuable public policies and effective implementation of the same to improve public service and delivery. This cannot be done without conviction and personal commitment. A public servant neither routinely switches job nor his dividends are as financially attractive as in personal business or the corporate sector, despite having competitive academic and professional abilities. Director General spoke about the 7th NFC award. I do tend to disagree with him a little. I believe that the provinces did use, and you could see the development that had gone on in the provinces in the last 10 years since the 7th NFC, the additional inflow of money into the provinces. In my opinion, and I've been having this argument of the Federation for a very long time, is that still, though there's talk of reducing the NFC award and rolling it back or taking back some money from the provinces, first of all, it's not constitutionally possible because there's an amendment in the Constitution now that you can't reduce the share of the provinces. Secondly, my opinion, the 7th NFC preceded the devolution under the 18th Amendment. So in fact, we need more money in order to take care of the additional responsibilities that we've been given. I'll just give you a very, a couple of examples here. The National Institute of Cardiovascular Disease, at the time that it was given to the provincial government, 2012, I believe, at that time, the expenditure of the Federation on NICVD was 900 million rupees. Last year, we gave them almost 9 billion rupees, and that is why it has improved. And you can see, we've made 7 satellite units. The NICVD in Karachi has the largest number of primary angioplasties under one roof anywhere in the world. And inshallah ta'ala, Sakhar would be the second largest once it is fully, operational, but in terms of getting up to scale. Another example is the Jinnah Hospital or the Jinnah Postgraduate Medical Center. I was the finance minister at that time. This was July of 2012, I believe. And the finance minister came over and told me that, we've got this new facility and we have not budgeted for it. 1st of July 2012, the federal government stopped all finances to Jinnah Postgraduate Medical Center. And at that time, we had to, I think it was 750 million or something. Right now, we're spending about 4.5 billion rupees on Jinnah Postgraduate Medical Center. So the provinces have actually improved the institutions that were given to them with the additional flow of money that we had. But still, my opinion, we should not be fighting over what is the share of the provinces or the federation. We need to increase the size of the pie. There is I'm sure there might be some people from FPR here. I know there are customs people here. The collections have to increase. I'll give you another example. We in the province collect agriculture income tax, and we've not been doing a good job of it. A lot of people think that there is no agriculture income tax and the agriculturists do not pay income tax. They might be avoiding agriculture income tax, but the law is there and they have to pay agriculture income tax. We're not doing a good job of it. One example was that people used to hide their income by mentioning agricultural income in their federal returns, and not paying the provinces the agriculture income tax. I had approached, and FPR was too stingy about sharing the database with us. But finally we managed, and I managed through, you know, not official channels, but managed to get the records from there. And then since a couple of years, our agriculture income tax collection has increased a little, but we need to do a lot more. One area that I do like to mention here is the sales tax on service. After, it was always a provincial tax. In 2000 or 2001, when there were no provincial assemblies, the governor at that time during the military regime had handed over that tax to the federal government, and they were collecting this tax until 2011-12. After the 18th Amendment, it was reiterated, the constitution was amended, and it explicitly said prior to that it was in the residual list, so it was to be collected by the provinces, but then it was explicitly stated that sales tax on service would go to the provinces, or the province who wants to collect it can do it. Sindh was the first province which opted to collect the sales tax on service. The first year, or when the last year that the federal government collected for us, they gave us 14.5 billion rupees for sales tax on service. The very first year we put our target to 25 billion, we've achieved that target. Last year that has passed, we've collected 100 billion. The target was 100, we collected a few, you know, 100 million, over 100 billion rupees in sales tax and service. The current year, the target is 120 billion rupees. So in my opinion, again, the provinces have to be trusted a little more. We are closer to the people. We provide service to them, and they are looking towards the provincial governments to provide service, and they have to have a larger role in tax collection and being closer to the people. We believe that we can do a much better job in collection of taxes. So the solution, in my opinion, is to devolve the sales tax to the provinces also. And we, the province of Sindh has given a proposal to the federal government. We've done that during the previous federal government. The NFC meetings have not been held yet, and we're going to reiterate our proposal there. And what we've said is that allow us, or allow whatever province wants to collect sales tax on goods, and the province should guarantee, for example, out of 100 rupees, say if 60 rupees is collected from the province of Sindh, under the head of sales, 60% is collected under the head of sales tax on goods, we will guarantee the 60 rupees. If we don't deliver, you can deduct our, you know, the amount from the divisible pool, which is to go to SIN. But if we collect 65, plus 5 rupees should go to us. Give an incentive to the provinces. We've been talking about it. The first reaction, obviously, from the federal government is that the provinces do not have the capacity. But I remind them that we do. And we've demonstrated that after Sindh, Punjab was the second province which started collecting. They formed the Punjab Revenue Authority. KPK and now even Balochistan is doing it themselves. So the provinces would have the capacity if they're given the responsibility. You are all going to, inshallah, get promoted soon, get into higher positions. The Director General spoke about the situation in the country right now. By the grace of Almighty Allah, we've had a very bad law and order situation in the entire country, especially in the province of Sindh and the city of Karachi. 10 years ago, and I'm talking about 2006-2007, I was at meeting somebody last night, and I had mentioned to them that even on the 4th of April, when we used to go from Sakhar to Gadi Khudabaksh, the Sakhar-Shikarpur road, we used to travel in convoys. And this is only 10, 11 years ago. In the rural areas, it wasn't possible in a lot of places to travel after sunset. Now, in the entire province, there's no place that you'd feel scared traveling to. The city of Karachi was a much bigger problem. We started 2008, we formed a coalition government, and we were hoping to work with our coalition partners to improve the law and order. Did not work. Finally, in 2013, the rangers were given certain tasks in the city of Karachi, and after 2015 we really got serious, in my opinion, to get the law and order under control, and by the grace of Almighty Allah we succeeded in that. And the example is the most recent problem that we had in the country. Sindh was the only province, perhaps Balochistan also, but Sindh was the only province where there were protests, there was blocking of traffic, but you could travel from any place in the province to wherever you wanted to reach with certain diversions, and we managed to do that, whereas I can't say the same thing about the other provinces. They were totally blocked. So we've got better we reach out to our people in a better way in the province of Sindh, and we've been able, by reaching out to people, we've been able to control this. At the same time, I say we can't be complacent, because both the terrorism, the people who want to perpetrate terrorism in our country are still active, and we need to make sure that we continue our resolve to give our citizens proper law and order, to give our citizens peace of mind so that they can go do their businesses, their children can go to schools, provide them with hospitals so that they can get their health facilities, and we've been trying that. A couple of other things that I want to mention, I don't know, I saw that you'd gone to some visits, the chief instructor mentioned it. Next time round, I would suggest that you take your team to Tharparkar. Because a lot has been said about Tharparkar in the news. Okay. You know, and I'd like you to give your views after you've visited Tharparkar, and you've seen what the government has done there in the last 10 years. The first time I went to Tharparkar was 2005, when Shaukat Aziz was contesting elections from Tharparkar. We started from Karachi, and to reach Mithi, it took us 8.5 hours. Now if you go there, you can get there in 4 hours, right up to Mithi. If you start from right here, you find the entire roads from right up from Nipa, Churangi it is called, and you go to Sharae Faisal, see the entire Sharae Faisal, the Karachi Thatta dual carriageway that has been made in the last couple of years, the roads from Thatta right up to Mithi. And if you want to fly, we've got an airport there also, which has been constructed by the government of Sindh through the Civil Aviation Authority, obviously, but it's been financed by the government of Sindh. The hospital in Mithi, we've heard so many, the issues are there. I'm not denying that the issue is not there. But the facilities that have been provided there, the problem is that we hear about so many deaths in the hospital of Mithi is because parents bring their children, the infants, the newborns, not only from Tharparkar, but even from adjoining districts. People from, parents from the district of Umarkot, Mirpur Khas, bring their children to Mithi because it's got a better facility, and that's why the rates are higher. But having said that, we are aware of the situation there. The government of Sindh provides free wheat to the residents of district Tharparkar, Umarkot, all the desert areas, and now we've also started a scheme that we're providing food packets to, and we've identified pregnant and lactating mothers in the district through the health department, and those homes we're providing with